Welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel. So I am gonna go ahead and film my nighttime skincare routine. I actually wasn't gonna film tonight, but look at my hair. I was like, I'm having a really, really good hair night. And I thought about like, what products do I use? Because if you've been following me for a little bit, I am postpartum and I had a lot of postpartum hair loss. And I had some volumizing shampoo and conditioner in my stash. So I decided that I was going to use them next when I ran out of shampoo and conditioner. And so I did, I'm using them. So these are from the brand Design Me and it is their Puff Me line. So Puff Volumizing. So this is their volumizing shampoo and conditioner. This is the shampoo, this is the conditioner. I am really impressed. Actually, I have only used them twice. The first time I used them, I didn't really see any kind of volumizing, but I also didn't, you know, like take my hair down and flip my hair over and kind of do this to it to tease it out. And then after I got out of the shower, I just put a little bit of the AG Hair Care Beach Balm. I didn't grab it, I'll put a picture. And that is actually a decent hairstyling product. And I've used it before. I don't think that that is what is responsible for my hair looking this good right now. I really have to say, I think that it is from the Design Me stuff. This Puff Me shampoo and conditioner. Look at that. So anyway, I was like, I'm having a really good hair night. I'm gonna film something. And I am not too proud to say that that is why I'm filming. Anyway, onto the skincare routine. So I already cleansed off camera and I am using the Good Molecules Rosewater Daily Cleansing Gel right now. They sent this to me. They sent me a few products of theirs to try and I really like this. It's not sponsored. They didn't ask me to do a video, but I finally got around to using this. Really, really like this. It's pretty much unscented. I don't smell anything when I use it. The bottle is glass and it's super affordable. It feels really gentle. If you're one of those people who likes a simple, unscented cleanser that does the job and does it gently and doesn't strip your skin, I don't have anything bad to say about this. I really, really like this. And their price point is amazing. And I just love it's a glass bottle. When they sent this to me, they sent it in a box that said something like, imagine a world without plastic. And it was just the whole aesthetic of it and how they presented it. It was just so well done. I'm really impressed by Good Molecules. I have been using this first and I'm using it to use it up. This is the Paula's Choice Exfoliate. It is their 2% BHA liquid exfoliant. So it's a salicylic acid essentially. And I gotta say, this is really, really well loved. I don't see what the big deal is. I don't think it's any more magnificent than a drugstore astringent. I just don't. I don't get it. It's supposed to help with blackheads. I actually have used it regularly for, you know, a week's long amount of time and I don't really see any improvement on myself. I'm not one who struggles a lot with that stuff though, so I could be the wrong person to ask. My opinions aside though, this is so well loved and I wish that I loved it as much too. I'm just using it to use it up. So when I use it, I do focus it just on my nose and chin. Primarily, and then some on my forehead. I kind of avoid, you know, the main cheek regions because I don't really have any blackheads or clogged pores that I need to deal with there. And then the next thing that I've been using, and this is almost gone, so I'll let you know what I think. This is the Pixi Skin Treats Glow Tonic. It's their 5% glycolic acid exfoliating toner. So this is an AHA toner. So I kind of use these in conjunction with each other. They do different things. AHA is like a chemical exfoliant just for your skin to bring out the fresher skin underneath, get rid of those old dead skin cells on top. I will say if I did use some sort of mask or cleanser that had an AHA or a BHA in it, I do skip these because you don't really want to overload your skin with these kinds of things. So my skincare has not been the most consistent since quarantine started. Pre-quarantine, I had a morning routine and a night routine and I stuck to it and I did it every single day. In quarantine, for some reason, I'm home all the time and I am not sticking to it every single day, but I was doing pretty good there for about a 6-week span and I was using this. That's why I've gotten through so much. And so I did use it very, very consistently for a while. I get up behind my ears and everything and I go down my neck. Usually I don't have a shirt on and I do my chest as well. So imagine that I'm doing all of this stuff on my décolleté as well. I think that's how you say it, but I'm just gonna skip that tonight. So I did get a chance to use this very consistently because for about 6 weeks there, I was being really, really good with my nighttime skincare. And this is really good stuff. I have to say that my skin just felt fresher and a little bit more glowy, which is great because it's called Glow Tonic, better. And I really did see a difference. And I really think it was because of this. So I like this. I think it's great. And then the next thing that I have been using lately is the Glow Recipe Plum Plump Hyaluronic Serum Deep Hydration Glow. And I got this in a trend mood box. Yes, I got this in a trend mood box. And I do like this a lot. I'm a little frustrated right now because the little tube doesn't go very far. So the pump has stopped getting the product to me when I use it. And there's still like a good amount left. You can see it stops right there. Oh, my nails aren't really that great right now, but it's right here. It's not like there's not a lot left in there. That's the frustrating thing about it. Other than that, I have been really liking this product. It supposedly is hyaluronic acid of like 5 different molecular weights so that it sinks down further into your skin than other hyaluronic acids might because they're only 1 molecular weight or less than 5. Anyway, so I've been having to remove the cap and just slowly pour some out. I don't know, maybe there is less in here actually than I think. Or I'm actually starting to get to the end, it looks like. You know what? I think that they fooled me. I think that it's got really thick glass on the bottom of the bottle. And I thought that that part was still the serum, but it's actually just the thick glass. So it looks like it still had stuff in it. So I am actually almost done with this. One thing I really like about using hyaluronic serums and hyaluronic essences is that when you use them and you put on your moisturizer before it's quite dry, your moisturizer goes a lot further. Okay, and then the next thing that I've been using is this Le Prunier. I don't speak French. It's a plum beauty oil. I have raved about this. A really good friend of mine sent this to me as a gift because she knew how much I liked it. It smells so good. It goes on so nicely. It just is very luxurious to use. And I am trying to use this up because at first I was nursing it because I loved it so much. And now I'm worried that I nursed it so long that it might be going rancid and I don't want that for sure. So I always just put like streaks onto my fingers and then I go like this when I use a beauty oil and I just put this on. And then for this, I kind of avoid the eyes right now because I am using an eye cream just because I happen to have it. But lately I've been kind of feeling like eye creams are just another thing for people to sell to us. And I haven't been pursuing them in my life, but I found this eye cream in my stash. I can't believe how fluffy this made my hair. And then the next thing I'm using right now is the Derma E Hydrating Night Cream. This also has hyaluronic acid in it and you can never get too much hyaluronic acid. So this is it. It's a really, really good size. I have seen this available at Ulta, Target, Walmart, I think it kind of is one of those products that you're like, is this drugstore or is this higher end? Not sure. I should price it. I'll put the price. I think it's really affordable. This is 2 ounces and I feel like that's on the larger side for night creams. And it is fairly rich, which is great because I have dry skin. So this feels really, really nice on my skin. I do like it. It's one of those products that's cruelty free. Oh, it's vegan actually even. So it goes that extra step and it's eco-ethical. I think I got this in a cause box actually at one point. It feels really nice and like weighty. It just feels good. I'm kind of sloppily slathering this onto my face right now. I always see people say you should work it up like this. I never do that. Do you do that? Leave a comment in the comments below. Do you do that? I just quickly and aggressively kind of rub this onto my face. Okay, and then this is the eye cream that I had found that I've been using that I actually really do like. This is by Frack. It's their So Jelly Cactus Eye Jelly with Plant Collagen. And it looks like this. It's kind of hard to see. I got this on a FabFitFun sale. People were going nuts about Freck being available on the sale, and I hadn't even heard of them, but other people were going nuts, so I was going nuts, and I felt like I needed to get something of theirs. So I got this, and actually now I'm pleasantly surprised. So I do my best to use my ring finger to apply eye cream. Gotta say, I don't always, but right now I'm gonna do it because I'm on camera. And this is actually a really nice eye cream. It is very, very cooling, and I like that a lot about it. And it goes on nicely. This is also a really sizable container. I don't think I've ever had an eye cream that was this big. It is 1.35 ounces. So I do like this a lot. I haven't seen it in a FabFitFun sale again ever since that one. And then that's it. That is my current nighttime skincare routine. Sometimes I will put on a sleeping mask. I usually wait a little bit, let this all kind of settle in, and then I'll put on a sleeping mask. And I may put that on later, but that is the gist for now. That is what I do every night, or I try to do every night. I mentioned I haven't been so good about it in quarantine, but I am really good about my skincare routine generally, just quarantine. I mean, there are some mornings where I realize I didn't even brush my teeth. So what is happening? Am I gonna leave that in this video? So that's it. That's my current skincare routine. Thank you for joining me. I hope you have a wonderful day. If you haven't subscribed, consider subscribing. Introduce yourself in the comments below, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.